Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and welcome to Ummah Radio. You are listening to the Tafseer class with myself, Abu Mus'ab. Alright, so we are still doing Tafseer ibn Kathir and we have just completed actually ayah number 13, and tonight inshallah we are starting with ayah number 14. So then without any delays, بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. So now آية number 14. وإذا لقوا الذين آمنوا قالوا آمنا وإذا خلوا إلى شياطينهم قالوا إنا معكم إنما نحن مستهزئون. It's actually two ayat which are joined together here. So we read number 15 as well. الله يستهزئ بهم ويمدهم في طغيانهم يعمهون. So in this ayah, these two ayat, Allah mentions, Allah is speaking still about the munafiqeen. So Allah says, وَإِذَا لَقُوا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا. When these people, these munafiqeen, these hypocrites, when they meet the believers, they say, we believe. Meaning we are Muslim, and they may claim and make as though they are believers when they are amongst the Muslims. But, وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ. But when they go back and they are alone with their shayateen, their friends, the rest of the kuffar, قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ. Then they say, إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ. Indeed, we are with you people. إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَهْزِئُونَ. We were just making jokes, meaning they were the believers. So Allah replies to them, and Allah says, اللَّهُ يَسْتَهْزِئُ بِهِمْ. Allah mocks them. They think they are mocking the believers, but Allah says that Allah is the one who is ridiculing them. They are not ridiculing the believers. وَيَمُدُّهُمْ فِي طُغْيَانِهِمْ يَعْمَهُونَ. And Allah prolongs their transgression, prolongs them to remain in their transgression and continue blindly in that manner. So they are, Allah ridicules them by leaving them in a state of, in a blinded state where they are in total transgression to their own selves. So that's the ayat. Now Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he moves on to the tafsir. He says, "Ay, wa idha laqiya ha'ula'il munafiqun al-mu'minin qalu amanna." Meaning, when these munafiqun, these hypocrites, when they meet the believers, they say, "We believe." Wa adhharu lahum al-iman wal-muwalah, and they openly appear to have iman, belief, and muwala. They show their allegiance openly only when they are amongst the believers. غُرُورًا مِنْهُمْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَنِفَاقًا وَمُصَانِعَةً وَتَقِيَّةً. But they only do this to try and deceive, it's deception from their side to try and deceive the mu'mineen out due to their hypocrisy and their lies and their taqiyah, their hiding of the truth. وَلِيُشْرِكُوهُمْ فِي مَا أَصَابُوا مِنْ خَيْرٍ وَمَغْنَمٍ. So that they can also take part in the spoils and the goodness and the booty which the believers have gotten. Obviously, this tafsir is now referring to like how every time when the jihad was taking place, the munafiqeen would always find some excuse to abstain from the battle, and after the Muslims had won and the spoils of war and everything had come in, then they would come and make the excuses and things so that they can get of the booty and things, because that is all they wanted, just matters of the dunya, and they had no share whatsoever of iman. So they would say, make these sort of statements and claims and things so that they can also get some of the goodness and some of the wealth and stuff that have come into the control of the Muslims. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ. But now when they go back to their shayateen, he say, يَعْنِي إِذَا انصَرَفُوا وَخَلَصُوا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ. Meaning when they turn away and they خَلَصُوا and they are alone to their shayateen. Okay, he'll explain now what he means by this. He say, فَضُمِّنَا خَلَوْا مَعْنَا انصَرَفُوا لِتَعَدِّيَتِهِ بِإِلَى لِيَدُلَّ عَلَى الْفِعْلِ الْمُضْمِرِ. If you look at the literal words of the ayat, if you take it word for word, what is actually saying, وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ, and when they are alone with to their shayateen, that's how it is in a literal form. But what Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, he says, what is included in this word خَلَوْا, خَلَوْا meaning alone, it it contains within this word here in sarafu, meaning they leave the believers and they go aside and they sit alone with their kuffar friends, and then they make that statement. They don't make it in the presence of the believers. So liyadulla ala al-fi'l al-mudmir, there is some hidden action which is taking place, which is mentioned in this word itself here, meaning that they first go away and then they sit alone with the shayateen and they make the statement. Wa shayateenihim sadatuhum wa kubara'uhum wa ru'asa'uhum min ahbar al-yahud. He says the shayateen that is mentioned here, it is their leaders, their elders, and their masters, their elders, and their leaders from the rabbis, of the Jewish rabbis. وَرُؤُوسُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقِينَ, and also the heads and the leaders of the mushrikeen and the munafiqeen. قَالَ سُدِي عَنْ ابْنِ مَسْعُودٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ يَعْنِي رُؤَسَاءَهُمْ فِي الْكُفْرِ. Imam Sudi rahimahullah, he reports from Hazrat Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, who said, commenting on the ayah وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَى شَيَاطِينِهِمْ, meaning when they go back to their shayateen, meaning their leaders in kufr. وقال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما هم أصحابهم من اليهود الذين يأمرونهم بالتكذيب وخلاف ما جاء به الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu, he commented and he said that the shayateen, it refers to the companions of the Jews who command them to disbelieve and to belie the deen of Islam and to go contrary to that which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam had come with. وقال مجاهد أصحابهم من المنافقين والمشركين. Imam Mujahid rahimahullah, he said that the shayateen, it refers to the companions of the hypocrites and the mushrikeen. وقال قتادة رؤوسهم وقادتهم في الشرك والشر. Imam Qatada rahimahullah, he says the shayateen refers to their leaders and those who, their heads and their leaders in shirk and evil. قال ابن جرير وشياطين كل شيء مردته. Imam Ibn Jarir rahimahullah, he now just explains about the usage of this word shayateen, that why is the word shayateen used in this ayah. Alright, so we were here with Imam Ibn Jarir rahimahullah, who said وَشَيَاطِينُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مَرَدَتُهُ. The shayateen of everything is مَرَدَتُهُ, meaning it's rebellious people. So the shayateen, the reason why shayateen is used in this ayah when they return to their shayateen, meaning basically the word shayateen refers to someone who is rebellious. Shaytan means a rebel. So these shayateen that these munafiqeen used to go to, all of them were rebels, in a nutshell. وَيَكُونُ الشَّيْطَانُ مِنَ الْإِنْسِ وَالْجِنِّ كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنْسِ وَالْجِنِّ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا. And he says that shayateen, and the word shaytan, you get it both from mankind and from jinnkind as well. Like how Allah Ta'ala mentions in another part of the Quran, شياطين الإنس والجن يوحي بعضهم إلى بعض زخرف القول غرورا. That the shayateen from man and from jinn, يوحي, that comes from the word وحي, but it means they are inspiring one another with the deceptive word, which the decorated words of deception. So the reason he's bringing this ayah here is to show that Allah mentions that you get shayateen from mankind and from jinnkind as well. Shaytan is not something restricted only to jinnkind. Any case, he continues on, he says, وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ. Allah Ta'ala continues on with the ayah and Allah says, these munafiqeen, they say, indeed we are with you. أي إن على مثل ما أنتم عليه. That meaning, indeed we are upon that which you are upon. إنما نحن مستهزئون. Indeed we were only joking. أي إنما نستهزئ بالقوم ونلعب بهم. Meaning, we were only joking and playing with those people. Meaning, they're telling this now to their munafiqeen, to their shayateen, that we were only joking and playing with these Muslims here. We are actually on the same kufr like you. وقال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما مستهزئون ساخرون بأصحاب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas رضي الله عنهما, he explained this word مستهزئون. He said that it means ساخرون, we are ridiculing the companions of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وقولوا تعالى جوابا لهم ومقابلة على صنيعهم الله يستهزئ بهم ويمدهم في طغيانهم يعمهون. Now Allah Ta'ala answers them and confronts them upon their doing. So Allah says, Allah يستهزئ بهم, that Allah ridicules them and Allah leaves them to wander blindly in their own transgression. قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما يسخر بهم للنقمة منهم. Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, he explains this, that how is this ridiculing taking place? He says, he mocks and ridicules them as a means of niqma, a punishment for them. وَيَمُدُّهُمْ يُمْلِي لَهُمْ, and he yumli imla, yumli yamuddu means to continue and to prolong. وَيَمُدُّهُمْ يُمْلِي لَهُمْ, and he prolongs for them, meaning their blindness and transgression. وَقَالَ مُجَاهِدْ يَزِيدُهُمْ. Okay, so it's basically just the different mufassirin, the how they translated the words, this word يَمُدُّ. Here it mentions يُمْلِي لَهُمْ, and Imam Mujahid rahimahullah, he says يَزِيدُهُمْ. So one means to prolong and one means to increase. In English, basically, we use the synonym, so the meaning comes out basically to be the same thing. Any case, so Imam Mujahid rahimahullah, he says, and Allah increases for them, they adds on to make it longer their transgression, their blind transgression that they are involved in. كَقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى أَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّمَا نُمِدُّهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ مَالِ وَبَنِينَ نُسَارِعُ لَهُمْ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ بَلْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ. Now here he's moving on to another, he moves on to quote another ayah of the Quran, and this is the normal method of Imam Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, that he always try to use the Quran first to make tafsir of another ayah of the Quran. So here he's trying to prove now this word yamudduhum, which basically is the word mad, to prolong, to make longer. So now he's using another ayah of the Quran as proof, or rather he's bringing it as a dalil, the way where Allah used this word in another occasion to mean the same sort of thing here. So this is the ayah which he has quoted here. The ayah which he has quoted is أَيَحْسَبُونَ أنما نمدهم به من مال وبنين نسارع لهم في الخيرات بل لا يشعرون. That do they think that we will increase for them their wealth and their children? نسارع لهم في الخيرات, by us hastening for them goodness. But in fact they don't understand. Any case, so in this ayah here, basically, what the reason he's quoting it is just only to prove this point, annama numidduhum, that do they think that we are increasing for them their wealth and their children because of us hastening for them goodness? But in fact, they don't perceive, they don't understand, they don't realize what is really taking place. So it's only for this word numidduhum that he has brought this ayah here. Any case, he continues on, he says, قال ابن جرير أخبر تعالى أنه فاعل بهم ذلك يوم القيامة في قوله تعالى: يوم يقول المنافقون والمنافقات للذين آمنوا انظرونا نقتبس من نوركم. So Imam Ibn Jarir rahimahullah, he says that Allah informs, Allah is giving information that he will do this with them on the day of Qiyamah. Like how Allah Ta'ala mentions in another ayah that on that day when the munafiqeen, male and female, they will say to the believers, wait for us and let us take some of your light. Because on the day of Qiyamah, the believers will have light all around them, while the obviously the kuffar, the munafiqeen, all of them, they will not have any light. In fact, they'll be shrouded in darkness. So now they will be looking for someone, or rather they would be trying to get some of the light from the believers so that they can make their way towards Jannah, which obviously is something that's never going to happen. But in any case, this is what they will now be saying on the day of Qiyamah. Any case, al-ayah, till the end of the ayah. وَفِي قَوْلِهِ وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ خَيْرٌ لِأَنفُسِهِمْ إِنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ لِيَزْدَادُوا إِثْمًا. Another ayah, he mentions that Allah used the same thing. وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Let the disbelievers not ever think that we prolong for them goodness for them. أَنَّمَا نُمْلِي لَهُمْ خير, that our prolonging of them is better for themselves. In fact, the prolonging of their lives and their transgression and everything like this is only to increase them in its sin and evil. So it's all related to the topic at hand, which to just put it in different words, he says that these people, despite the evil and the crimes and everything that they are doing, you'll find that they have, most of the time, they have good lives, they are in position of power, they have lots of wealth, they have lots of children, everything seems to be going their way. It does not mean that it is good for them. They think it themselves, and some people mistakenly amongst the Muslims also seem to think so. But that is not the case, as Allah mentions here. They should never, and Allah uses the word, وَلَا يَحْسَبَنَّ, they should never ever think that it is good for them, that Allah is doing something good for them by increasing their lifespan and everything like this. But in fact, the reason why Allah increases their lifespan and gives them a more and more and more things like this is liyazdadu ithma, so that they can fall deeper and deeper into sin, so that they with the, it's like piling sin upon sin upon sin until eventually there's, they get taken just like that and flung into the fire of Jahannam. Okay, so a question here. So what if a Muslim has a good life and good health? Should they be worried? No, it is not a means of worry. In fact, it is one of the du'as we always make. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyah wa mu'afati al-dini wal-dunya wal-akhirah. That we always asking Allah for afu, which is forgiveness, and afiyah, which is like a good life and good health and all these sort of things. So no, it is not a bad sign like this. Obviously, a person always does looks at himself and yuhasibu nafsa. He takes himself to account and sees that am I on the right path or am I on the wrong path. This is something that a person does on a daily basis. So no, if a Muslim has a good life, and there are many Muslims who have good lives that Allah has given the world basically in front of them, and they make use of it in the path of Allah. So it's not we know many of the Sahaba radiyallahu anhum who are very rich. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu, Hazrat Uthman radiyallahu anhu, other Sahaba radiyallahu anhum as well, who Allah had granted them wealth, and without any hesitation they had spent their wealth in the path of Allah. So the only time a person should be worrying is if Allah has given you good health and you don't make use of it in the right manners, and if Allah has given you wealth and you don't make use of it in the correct avenues. So that is the only time a person should be worrying. If Allah has given you so much wealth, you don't pay your zakah. If Allah gives you good health and you don't even perform your salah. So this is when a person should be worrying. But generally, if Allah gives you good health, lots of wealth, lots of children and everything like this, it's not a bad sign that you should be worried about it. Wallahu a'lam. Okay, so next follow-up question. Allah says He will test us, though. Yes, Allah mentions that indeed, most definitely, Allah will test you with regards to the loss of life and property and wealth and all these sort of things. This is the وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. That's why Allah says that definitely we will test you بِشَيْءٍ, and yeah, بِشَيْءٍ is another thing which Allah mentions, with a little bit of something, مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ of fear, وَالْجُوعِ and hunger. So it's not that you will have no food. Okay, the levels of tests differs from person to person, that Allah decides and that we have no control over. But it's not that every single person must go through a stage where he has no food, or that everyone must go through a stage where everybody in his family dies and things, or that he's in a total state of fear, you don't know who, he's surrounded by the enemy and things like this. It's not that everyone will undergo it. It's little bits of things that Allah will test a person with accordingly. So some may go through a great amount of tests and some may go through less tests. Allah tests people according to their amount. If you look at the ayah itself from an Arabic perspective, shay, the word bishayin. Now shay, as you know, we have, if we through the Arabic classes, we have something which is known as ma'rifa and nakira. When now nakira can mean from the least amount to the largest amount. So here in this ayah, it means like it can apply from the least amount that Allah will test you with only a little bit of fear or a little bit of hunger or a little bit of one of these things, or alternatively, Allah will test you with a lot of fear and a lot of hunger and things like this. But Allah does not, la yukallifu Allahu nafsan illa wus'aha, so Allah does not burden a person more than what they can bear. So when Allah tests a person for whatever reason and however, whichever way it may be, Allah only tests a person to their capabilities. So it's not that if there's a person that fear is something he can't handle, then Allah will test him maybe in a different way. Maybe Allah gives him hunger or something like that. But it's not necessary that each and every single one of these things that you will definitely suffer from, or rather be tested with. والله أعلم. Okay, so to continue on الآية, the end of the آية. We were still doing ولا يحسبن الذين كفروا أنما نملي لهم خير لأنفسهم إنما نملي لهم ليزدادوا إثما, that آية. So now to continue on, he says قال فهذا وما أشبهه من استهزاء الله تعالى ومكره وخديعته بالمنافقين وأهل الشرك. So he mentions here that this آية and the other آيات which are similar to it, it is from how the استهزاء, I don't like using the word mockery, because in English, it for other people it may make sense, but not quite really the correct word to use here. But any case, it means the how Allah ridicules these munafiqeen and the ahlush and the mushrikeen and the plans and the khadi'a means like the deception, but of course we don't say that Allah deceives. So any case, we look for a different word, because we would say that Allah plots and these people these people plot and Allah plans. We don't like using bad words for Allah. They are doing the evil, Allah just uses the same word again as we did pass by in a previous class. So any case, all these things, they are trying to mock the believers, so to ridicule the believers, so Allah used the same word back again that Allah ridicules them. So any case, he says all these similar ayats is from the how Allah ridicules these people, these munafiqeen and mushrikeen, and the plans of Allah with regards to them. وَقَالَ آخَرُونَ إِسْتِهْزَاؤُهُمْ تَوْبِيخُهُ إِيَّاهُمْ. Other mufassirin, they had said that the istihza, this ridiculing of them that Allah does, is His reprimanding of them. وَلَوْمُهُ لَهُمْ عَلَى مَا ارْتَكَبُوا مِنْ مَعَاصِيهِ, and He's blaming them, meaning that Allah, how Allah blames them for taking part in those things which are in his disobedience. Meaning, basically, another way, and Allah reprimands them and blames them for engaging in his disobedience. وقال آخرون قوله الله يستهزئ بهم وقوله يخادعون الله وهو خادعهم وقوله نسوا الله فنسيهم وما أشبه ذلك إخبار من الله أنه مجازيهم جزاء الاستهزاء ومعاقبهم عقوبة الخداع فأخرج الخبر عن الجزاء مخرج الخبر عن الفعل الذي استحق العقاب عليه فاللفظ متفق والمعنى مختلف. Okay, yeah, he mentions it actually. He says, other mufassirin, what they had said is, with regards to the ayah, Allahu yastahzi'u bihim. And the ayah, yukhadi'una, okay, let me just again run through the translation. Allahu yastahzi'u bihim, that Allah ridicules them. Wa qawluhu, yukhadi'una Allahu wa huwa khadi'uhum. They try to deceive Allah, but Allah is deceiving them. Like I say, we don't like using the word deceive. Any case, وَقَوْلُهُ نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَنَسِيَهُمْ they forget Allah فَنَسِيَهُمْ. Now, one thing we know, that Allah never forgets anything. Literally, this would mean that فَنَسِيَهُمْ, that Allah forgets them. But that is incorrect, because Allah never forgets anyone. فَنَسِيَهُمْ here would be that Allah ignores them. Not that Allah forgets them, but they are not concerned about Allah, so Allah is not concerned about them. So he says, all these similar type of ayat, it's informing ikhbaru min Allahi annahu majazihim jaza' al-istihza, that Allah is going to take them to task as a result of the istihza, their mockery, wa mu'aqibuhum 'uqubatul khida', and that Allah will also take them to task for the deception. So, فَأَخْبَرَ الْخَبَرِ عَنِ الْجَزَاءِ مَخْرَجَ الْخَبَرِ عَنِ الْفِعَلِ. So, this is now from a linguistic perspective. He's saying that Allah is actually mentioning here that it's not that Allah is going to deceive them, or that Allah is going to ridicule them, or that Allah is going to forget them, but rather it's that Allah will punish them for their ridiculing, Allah will punish them for their deception, and Allah will punish them for forgetting Him. This is what is actually being said, but it's an Arabic way of phrasing the sentence that it looks as though you are making a statement that Allah will ridicule them, but in fact it means something entirely different, that Allah will punish them and take them to task as a result of their ridiculing. So he says, فَاللَّفْظُ muttafiq, that the word like istihza, khida' and nisyan, that ridiculing, deception and forgetfulness, the word is the same that Allah uses, but وَالْمَعْنَى مُخْتَلِفْ, but the meaning is totally different. What they are doing is this forgetting and deception and ridiculing, but Allah is not doing any of those things. Allah is punishing them as a result of their mocking, their ridiculing, their deception and all these other things. So, and he explains it further. He says, كما قال تعالى وجزاء سيئة سيئة مثلها وقوله فمن اعتدى عليكم فاعتدوا عليه. He says, like how Allah Ta'ala mentions in another part of the Quran, and the recompensation of an evil is a like evil. So you do something bad, then something bad is what you are deserving. And in another ayah, Allah says, whoever transgresses upon you, then transgress upon him. The way that it's the same word which is being used, but it is a different meaning which is intended. فَالْأَوَّلُ ظُلْمٌ وَالثَّانِ عَدْلٌ. The first one is oppression and the second one is justice. So let's take this word here for example. فَمَنْ اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ, whomsoever transgresses upon you. فَاعْتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ, literally, then transgress upon him. The first transgression from the enemy's perspective here now, this is oppression, this is ظُلْم. فَعَتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ, then you transgress upon him. This is now justice. What it's actually meaning is, you must now fight back, repel him, and take justice for yourself. And the word used here is transgress also, meaning tit for tat. What they do to you, you do back to them. So it may appear to be transgression, but in fact it is justice. So he says, لفظهما وإن اتفق لفظهما فقد اختلف معناهما. So he says that despite the in these type of words, despite the fact that the word is the same, but its meanings are different. وإلى هذا المعنى وجه كل ما في القرآن من نظائر ذلك. So he says, and with this sort of meaning, once you have understood all of this, all the rest of the ayat of the Quran, which has this thing, this type of meaning, where Allah uses these sort of words with regards to, like wamakaru wamakar Allah, all these sort of words. Whenever Allah uses these sort of sentences, all of it falls under the same banner of this understanding here, that what they are doing is transgression, and what Allah is doing is justice, and Allah is not doing any transgression or any deception or anything like this, but rather Allah is punishing them as a result of their transgression and their plannings and plottings and all sorts of things like that. He then moves on. He says, وَالْعَمْهُ الضَّلَالَ. Yeah, this amhu, this means blindness, and as we did in the ayah, في طغيانهم يعمهون, it's this word here, يعمهون, that he is dealing with now. So he says, العمه is الضلال, it is misguidance. يقال عمها إذا ضل. This is now from a linguistic perspective again, that it is said that عمها عمهن, that he becomes blind, إذا ضل, when he goes astray. وقوله في طغيانهم يعمهون أي في ضلالتهم وكفرهم يترددون حيارا. That the ayah في طغيانهم يعمهون, they are wandering blindly in their transgression, أي in the في ضلالتهم وكفرهم, in the misguidance and the كفر, يترددون حيارا, they are wandering just hopelessly, they're just hopelessly wandering, they don't know where they're going. لا يجدون إلى المخرج منه سبيلا لأن الله قد طبع على قلوبهم وختم عليها وأعمى أبصارهم عن الهدى فلا يبصرون رشدا ولا يهتدون سبيلا. He say they are wandering in blindness. لا يجدون إلى المخرج منه سبيلا. They find no path to exit from this blindness of theirs. Why? Because Allah has sealed their hearts and closed it up. وَأَعْمَى أَبَصَارَهُمْ عَنِ الْهُدَى, and made their eyes blind to the guidance. فَلَا يُبْصِرُونَ رُشْدًا وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ سَبِيلًا, so they cannot see the guidance. وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ سَبِيلًا, nor can they be guided to the straight path. So he then says, وَقَالَ بَعْضُهُمْ الْعَمْهُ فِي الْقَلْبِ وَالْعَمْهُ فِي الْعَيْنِ وَقَدْ يُسْتَعْمَلُ الْعَمْهُ فِي الْقَلْبِ أَيْضًا كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَلْ أَبَصَارُ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَلْ قُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. Other Mufassirin, they commented also and they said that الْعَمْهُ فِي الْقَلْبِ وَالْعَمْهُ فِي الْعَيْنِ. You have two types of blindness. You have blindness of the eyes, or rather you have blindness of the heart, and you have blindness of the eyes. And this word, عَمَى, blindness, has been used for the heart as well, like Allah Ta'ala mentions, فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَلْ أَبْصَارُ, because indeed, it is not the eyes which is blind, وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَلْ قُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ, but rather it is the hearts in the chests which is blind. So, at times Allah uses this word that they are wandering in blindness, not that the eyes are blind, that they're going around hopelessly like this, but rather that their hearts are totally blind, and blind to the truth and the guidance, and that is why they wander hopelessly in kufr and misguidance. So that is the end of the tafsir of ayah number 14 and ayah number 15, and inshallah on this point here we will end for now. Until next week, when we will continue again from ayah number 16. So until then, we will end for now when we say, وَصَلَى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ وَبَارَكَ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَبِحَمْدِهِ سُبْحَانَكَ اللَّهُمَّ وَبِحَمْدِكَ نَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنْتَ نَسْتَغْفِرُكَ وَنَتُوبُ إِلَيْكَ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.